You would think.
Well, good evening. Glad you guys came out to celebrate this Christmas Eve with us, the coming and the first advent of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We also want to take this time to say Merry Christmas to Pastor Chad Boswick and his family. They couldn't be with us tonight. So to Chad, to Cheryl, Jeremy, Junior, and Riley, we say Merry Christmas and too bad you can't be with us in Remnant. So, anyway, God bless, and we're going to sing and talk about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you, Lord, for those that are here. Lord, those that couldn't make it. We ask, Father, that your spirit would encourage, build up, Lord, and realize that you came for a reason. And, Lord, that reason was we needed a deliverer. We thank you for it. We praise your holy name, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Glad to have you with us this evening.
Thank you.
Did you know that the Christmas story actually begins clear back in Genesis? And that it was promised that through Abraham, all nations, tribes, tongues, peoples would be blessed by this event. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid. Take Mary to be your wife, for that which she has conceived is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated, God is with us. And then Joseph, being aroused from his sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took her to be his wife. And did not know her until she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
Oh, come, oh, come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel. That of hell thy people say.
One of the minor prophets, chapter 5, verse 2, that Bethlehem was actually foretold to be the city where Christ would be born. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. The census first took place while Quirinius was governor in Syria. So while all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. And then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all the people. For there is born unto you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel, a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill towards men." And so it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let's now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which they were told by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told them.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
this next little piece of story is prophesied about in Psalm 72. Now I'm in Matthew. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who was born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and the scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'But you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are not the least among the rulers of Judea. For out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go, search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring word back to me, that I may come and worship him also." When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him of gold, of frankincense, and of myrrh. And then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to King Herod, they departed for their own country another way.
Leading still.
To the blind man.
In the book of Galatians, Paul writes, "But when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of his Son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then you're an heir of God through Christ." You know, I can't help it. Is there anything better than the salvation of Jesus Christ? Not only that saves the soul for eternal life, but that gives us an adoption to become children of the Most High God. Not to be arrogant about it, not to lord it over people, but to humbly be thankful and grateful that he sent his only son. Yes, he was born and we celebrate today. But he also died and he shed blood and he rose again so that we could have that righteousness covering us. There's nothing better. There's no better gift given to us in this world. Because you can't buy it with money. You can't buy it with time. You can only accept it and open it up. Open up this gift and really study it through, and you'll be amazed at the rest of your life and the life to come. So if you would like to, we're going to sing Silent Night. If you'd like to come forward and sing to with us, be great. If you want to stay in your seat, that's fine. If you want to come up and talk about Jesus, that's really what it's all about. If you've never accepted him, do it as soon as you possibly can, like right now. You'll never, ever, ever regret it.
Oh,
morning glad to know that Jesus Christ absolutely is alive. He's amazing. You know, you can't help but think as you look at this time and the season, it brings about a lot of memories from kids to grandparents to families, and I can't help but think that my mom, my pastors who were uncles and granddads who've gone on in the ministry, they're there already. But see, that little baby that was born, he would grow up to take every one of you and I's sin upon himself. And by doing that, he came so that you and I could have eternal life. See, the neat part about that is it's awesome to be able to celebrate this first Advent. But there was a second event that happened, and it was on a cross. And there he bled and he died to pay for every one of our sins. But then he didn't just leave it there. There was a third day, and he rose from that grave. And when he rose from that grave, he said, I am the first in the resurrection. And he said, blessed are they who will have a part in that first resurrection. Well, I got news for you. We're celebrating now, but there's a day coming.
Yes.
Ooh, come on now. Because the greatest gift we ever got came when Jesus Christ gave his life that you and I could receive salvation. I've been asked over many, many times after coming to Christ, you ever think about going back? Going back to what? I was a slave to sin. But now I'm free in Jesus Christ. The word declares that we're not ashamed of the gospel, for it's the power and the salvation. So while we may see a cute baby, I see God coming. That he could be touchable. Come on. The Old Testament didn't know him like you and I could know him. He came in the flesh. And everything we need to know about our God is revealed in Jesus Christ through his word. And I don't know about you, we always talk about it, but there's a day I'm going to get to see him face to face. Amen? You with me? Come on. And I don't know if we'll stop shouting or we'll be on our faces first and awe of what a great, magnificent king he truly is. Because folks, truly, there's a day he's going to be revealed as the king of all kings. Not the prime minister of Britain, not Trump, not Biden, not our Congress, not any of the other kings on this earth. He is the king above all kings. And that beautiful story turns around and says, I won't leave you comfortless. When you call upon me, I'm going to send your Holy Spirit, my Holy Spirit, and he'll indwell you. And the scripture says in Ephesians that that filling of that Holy Spirit is sealing you till the day he comes back and gets you. See, we could be celebrating right now and he might show up. And the Bible says he knows his own. So when you're sitting around John at the table and we're opening up those gifts, remember the greatest gift of all that was ever given was given by God himself. His son is blessed Jesus Christ who paid for all of our sins. I like how that lyric said, he came to be born once so that we could be born again. Thank you, Jesus. Now, I know we have some Pentecostal folks in here. We got some Lutheran folks in here. We got some Catholic folks in here. We got all kinds in here today. But let me just say this to you. It isn't a Pentecostal thing. It's not a Catholic thing. It's not a Lutheran thing. The Bible tells us that we're to lift our hands and give him praise. So I'm going to ask if Jocelyn would sing this one more time. And as they do, would you sing it to him? He's the audience we really want. Amen. Would you do that this morning, this evening with us? Thank you. this evening? How many of you have some relatives or friends that are really close to you that don't know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior? We're coming to the end of this year. Wouldn't it be awesome to see him come in 2020? But how many believe that by what God's doing in the middle of our country, I believe that people are once again waking up. He is our only consistent, constant we can depend on entity in Jesus Christ. I don't know if he's coming tonight, but I'll tell you one thing, I'm believing for God to touch and to redeem my family members, friends, and family this year. It's coming. Amen? And I'm going to tell you something that I really consider a privilege, and I mean this from the bottom of our heart, all of us up here and out there. Our church families have grown together, Remnant and Refuge. I don't even know the difference anymore, really, other than some meet at 2 and some meet at 10. But I couldn't be more proud of my family than to be proud of all that God has blessed me and our church family. You were so beautiful to hear you sing and to worship our Jesus tonight. So, in closing, I know Jocelyn, I love to hear her sing, but you know really what touches our heart would bless us, bless our Lord, is we would start you off on pitch and you would sing, that we could hear you. Would you just, I don't care if you're on or off, I just want to hear you sing. Because really, guys, and Jocelyn, is it a beautiful sight to see them worship? And you don't know how pretty it is to look that way. We're going to get you started, and we'd just love to hear you sing as we close this out tonight. Would you start them, Jocelyn? Would you give him thanks? Thank you, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And we praise your name. Well, we have truly been blessed to get to be with you. We're thankful that we get to be with our family. Yes. By blood and by blood. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you and have a Merry Christmas.
And you too. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.